A Journey to the Celestial World, Chapter 1, My Background. I hope this testimony will impact your life. I went through a difficult times in my walk with the Lord. I spent more than 2 years in unemployment and hardship. One day I said, Lord, I know it's you allowing these hard times so that you can sort out things in my life. But I'm sure in the end of all this, there is a gate open for me. I put my trust in you. Actually, I took that opportunity in order to seek the face of the Lord in all my heart in prayer, in order to enter the purpose of God and the promised land ahead. The whole thing began an evening in a church where we were invited. The speaker said, I was in the ministry for some time and I knew the truth, but in my heart I wanted to see the Lord. I wanted to see His wonders in my eyes. I knew that the Lord was tremendous. Thus there was a yearning in me to see His hand, His power and His wonders. I wanted something new in my experience and walk with Him. This pastor began to tell his testimony. He said, one day in Brazil in Black Stream region, I saw a car moving in the road in a speed of 60 to 80 kilometers per hour. The car was moving in a great speed. Suddenly I saw a child crossing the road right in front of the vehicle. When I saw this scene I shouted for God mercy. But the driver was not able in that speed to stop that car. In the twinkling of an eye, I heard the noise of the child beneath the car. He was underneath the car but he survived. He was crying but he survived. After that accident, at night before sleeping I prayed as usual. I said, Lord, I need to see a wonder before my eyes. All my experience are past experience. I want to see your wonder before my eyes. I want to have a new experience with you. That night when I fell asleep, in the morning I began to see the scene of the accident repeating itself, exactly the way it happened in the day, at the exact place of the avenue, and it was with that very vehicle. I saw when the child was passing in front of the car. However, I saw one thing that I did not see in the day during the accident. At that moment when the accident happened, I saw a brightening angel of God lifting the car and the child passing under the car and surviving the accident. Before rising from that dream, the brightening angel of the Lord told me, is this not a wonder before your eyes? It was then I came to realize that the survival of this child in that accident was in itself a wonder before my eyes, but I failed to see it. God is always doing wonders before us but we fail to see them. When I heard this testimony I began to seek experience with the Lord. I wanted continuous experience with the Lord. Then one experience happened to me that marked my whole life. In truth, the Lord is always doing wonders throughout our life. God is doing wonders in your personal life and in your family more than you think. I started praying to God because the desire to see Him was born in me. I needed a wonder before my eyes. I was willing to pay the price of that experience. I started praying and I would pray in the morning prayer. When the morning prayer ended, I would continue to pray. I would go home, take shower and come back in the church to pray. Then one day, the shepherd came to me and said, I feel like establishing you as the third young leader of the church. I said, Pastor, I am ready to do God's work, but this will happen after months of looking for God's presence and signs. Yet although I was praying, there was silence from heaven. There was nothing happening. The heaven seems shut down and brazened. Moreover, my brothers and sister of my stepmother were unemployed like me, until one day we went to look for a job. We got that job, and we did that job for 1 month. We got the money and then we were told that the work was finished. We bought provision. One day I went to church. When I arrived the service had already started, and I sat on the last seat. The pastor was preaching. Suddenly he said, thus said the Lord, you there in the striped shirt, you sat there in the background because you were ashamed of your torn shirt on the shoulder. You sat there in the background because of shame. God say you are just passing the cloud of darkness, but it is already coming off you, and God say, He will give you a new experience and tremendous encounter. God will come with providence in your life. Therefore from today you must glorify God despite your hardship. I was very pleased to hear this. Few days later, God told me through the pastor, you're going to preach in the church today. But I was in distress and my heart was disturbed because of prolonged unemployment and hardship. I refused to preach in my heart. I was crying in anguish, and then suddenly I heard a beautiful voice. It was a tremendous voice that said, look ahead. I thought someone was talking to me. When I raised my head in the middle of the congregation among the sisters, I saw a beautiful river running over. On that day I preached and I asked people to make decision to come to Christ. A very young girl came when I prayed for her. She began to speak unknown language. Many were filled with the Holy Spirit. Chapter 2, Journey to the Celestial World. And when we were coming back home, it was deep dark, only the lights of houses that lit up the road. My little sister was speaking unknown languages. We were singing and praising the Lord God on the way. As we were moving, we saw like a flash of light behind us. We all noticed that the light was accompanying us as we were moving. When we arrived home, I looked back. I saw the flash of light disappearing. Then suddenly I saw a golden trumpet, and a sword of fire that was illuminating. This was happening while we were speaking strange languages. I wanted to ask my sister if she was seeing what I was seeing, but she kept talking in unknown language. Then I said to a brother called Israel, "Are you seeing what I'm seeing?" "I'm seeing a trumpet of gold and a sword of fire in the high." Finally we arrived at the house gate. The vision ended. My little sister that was in the spirit asked me, "Was it an electric light from the pole?" But I was confused. When we got inside the house, we found brothers and sisters inside praising together. When we began to praise, people were falling. All I remember is that I saw someone holding me. Later I did not see anything else. When suddenly I found out that I was standing in the bed, my little sister was lying on the bed next to my body. I noticed that my spirit was standing and my body was laying on the bed. My stepmother and people were observing me and my little sister with desperate looks. Suddenly I saw brightening angels of the Lord inside the room in which we were. They looked at me and they said, "The Lord has heard the prayer of your heart. Hosanna. Mystery are to be revealed." At that moment I was still observing my body and I was amazed to look at it. I watched the shining angel looking at my sister. They were all in brightening white garment. They held my hand and that of my sister and we began to rise through the roof of the house. Then we stopped midway through. I remember that my stepmother bent on her knees and began to pray, saying to God, "She is my only daughter. Please Lord, bring her back to life. She is my one and only daughter." In the meantime, people were hitting her heart in order to check her pulse. Then I saw the stepmother massaging my sister's heart. One angel was holding my hand, but the other angel who was taking my little sister beyond the roof brought her back and put her spirit inside her body again. Immediately she woke up crying. She observed the beloved mother and said, "What is wrong with you, mother? Why did you do this?" It was a beautiful place. I was doing well. Chapter 3, The Gate of Heaven. The angel of the Lord looked at me and said, "Joel, the Son of God could not bear your prayers anymore, and God has answered you today. Come with us." At that moment I saw the roof of the house disappearing. An hour later we began to fly in space in a tremendous speed. When we rose to the space, I started observing and admiring the stars. I was observing the stars in space passing all over the place. They were beautiful. But we were moving in such a tremendous speed, and suddenly we arrived before a beautiful gate. It was all golden. There were radiant angels dressed in white holding flashing sword. I noticed by my side a child who stood at the gate of heaven. He was transported by an angel who informed the guardian angel at the gate that the child came to dwell in the kingdom. The child stood in awe and he was admiring this city of light and glory. The angel that brought me said to the two guarding angels at the gate, "He has come to receive revelation of mystery. I'm inviting you beloved to ask for an experience today. Tonight the powerful presence of the Holy Spirit of God will give you something especially from God. Someone has not seen it because there's a price to pay, but it's worth it. It's worth the price." When that gate opened, the angels gave way for us to enter. Angel that came to take me are the one that took me around the heavenly world and showed me everything. When we enter the gate of heaven, it was glorious. I was contemplating the glory in the horizon. It was something pretty. The Lord was sitting on a beautiful throne. The glory was tremendous, abounding and increasing, so much so that I could not stand, and I fell on my knees. Suddenly that angel that was on my side held me and got me up and said, "We had the conditions for you to see the glory of God." When he said that, I got up. I could not bear the glory, yet I was far away from the Son of God. I was with the angel of the Lord and I was observing the cosmos. When I looked, I saw my body on the earth on the side of my stepmother and my brothers. They were crying around the bed, and I saw how she was asking me to come back, she cried. I saw when she called an ambulance. I heard everything they were saying as she continued to cry. At that moment, I heard the voice of the Lord Jesus resounding and saying to me, "You have been asking me for an experience, and I have answered your request as the God of revelations and peace, but I do not want your family and people to mess with your body while your spirit is with me. You will have to go back sooner because your body is in critical condition." Then the angel began to show me the celestial kingdom of God. I said to the angel, "I will stay here. I do not want to go back to earth." The angel said, "Your body is dying. It is in the last minutes of life. You will need to go back sooner." The angels hugged me in order to say goodbye, but I pushed him back. I said, "I want to stay. I am not going back." Chapter 4. The Tree of Life. The angel that was showing me the city held me by the hand. We passed a beautiful bridge. Under this bridge I saw which crystalline water, that was transparent and pure as glass, that was passing under the bridge, and we went to a place that had a beautiful lawn that was so green, you never seen it on the earth. There was a beautiful tree. Around this tree I saw several saints of heaven. They were dressed in white garment of brightening light. I heard them saying, "Holy, holy is the Lord of armies that fill the heaven with his glory." Suddenly there were outbreak of beautiful golden color. Then I saw the flaming chariot of light landing around the tree of life, that had many branch, which bear fruit every season, where the saint of heaven were gather. When the Lord got off the celestial vehicle, he said, "This is the tree of life prepared for the great victory day. To the one who is victorious I will grant the right to eat of the tree of life in the paradise of God." Then he took me by the hand with him. I said, "Lord, I know many loved one who have passed away. I would like to see them." Actually I was thinking these thing. I did not speak verbal word, yet whatever I thought the Lord answered my thought. I never open my mouth in heaven. In the celestial world many times I just had to think, and he answered my thought. He said to me, "You will see people when it's necessary. I know that you want to see people. Come with me, I'll show you someone." Then we enter in a very beautiful and stupendous building that was overwhelming. There were thousands and thousands of people dressed in radiant and resplendent white robes. They were rehearsing. I observed that they were rehearsing, but nobody was singing anymore because they had finished. It was a time of silence before the Lord. Then I noticed someone in the crowds. The Lord said, "Joel, this is the person you wanted to see. She is here." The Lord showed me my mother that I lost 14 years ago. My mother was with a very beautiful lady from our community. Beloved, we often despair when we lose a relative, but those who have died in Christ are in the glory. One day we will see them again. When I saw my mother coming, she was filled with radiant light and glory. I saw the glory of God in the face of my mother. Chapter 5, The Crown of Life. When I met my mother I say to her, "Morning mother, I'm here in heaven too." She said, "My son, this is the time of silence. We are not supposed to talk here. Otherwise we will interrupt the glory in this meeting here." Then my mother took me away from that room that was filled with people. We entered another beautiful room. There were thousands and thousands of crowns and stationery scattered across. They were adorned with crystals. However, the roof and the ground of this stationery room was gold pure. There was a stairs that had 6 steps, but we didn't need to climb up and down the stairs. Actually we were floating over the 6 steps that I saw. Beloved, in the years ahead, in the eternal age of the kingdom of light, we will not need to walk. We will be flying and floating. This is the things that God has prepared for his people, things that had never entered men's imagination. Glory to God. We did not walk, we were floating. How many times when I am going to church I was saying it's far, because I have to walk, but there in the heavenly world you will float in the presence of God like angels. I was admiring the spacious hall where crowns were kept. I asked my mother whether they sell these crowns. She told me, "It belonged to the Lord." There were thousands of them. I saw beautiful celestial stones that were shining. There were thousands of beaming, glittering and precious pebbles that were used in order to adorn these crown. There were also crown that had few or no precious stones. I asked my mother about my crown. She said, "You cannot see it now because you're going back to earth. You will not stay." I replied to my mother, "I want to stay. I am not going back." My mother said, "Son, you cannot stay. You have to go back and serve. You can see that some crowns have several precious stones and other have few precious stones. My mother said, each soul that you will win for God on the earth is equal to a precious stones on your crown. And when you win many souls, you will have many precious stones and adornment on your crowns. Many crowns are missing precious pebbles here, because God people on the earth do not want to work for God. People of God do not care about winning souls. Their crowns lacked precious pebbles. These precious stones you are seeing over there are for martyrs, people who give their lives for the gospel. They are also precious pebble for people who intercede and cry to God for lost souls. Beloved, tonight in the presence of God, let us cry for the souls that are dying in the city in our country Brazil. Let the soul winner stand in the presence of the Master and cries, it's worth your sacrifice. Then we left that hall. Chapter 6. The arrival of the overcomer in paradise. I was in the paradise in this city of gold when I saw the gate of heaven opening. I saw the angel of the Lord bringing a man who died in Christ and landed before the pearly gate of the celestial kingdom. He was dressed in pure white. The man joined a party of angels that were singing in paradise. The angels of light were flying. They were sounding golden harp and playing instrument made of celestial gold. I asked the Lord about the meaning of this celebration in paradise. The Lord said, son, there is always festivity and celebration when a saint die on the earth and arrive in the paradise. My angels celebrate with music and feast the arrival of saint who made it in paradise. I saw this believer who was an overcomer joining this feast in paradise that was organized for the newly arrived souls. Then I saw the Lord standing up, and he welcomed the man personally and he showed him his hands and the marks. After being welcomed by the Lord, he was taken to the chambers of silence in order to be rewarded for the work he has done for the kingdom of heaven, and receive the appropriate crowns adorned with precious stones. I heard a voice from heaven saying, blessed are the dead, those who die in the Lord from this moment on. Yes, says the Spirit, they will rest from their labors, for their deeds will follow them. When he was taken to that hall of rewards, they went around a very nice separate door, and I followed them behind. I approached the Lord who held my hand and told me, touch not open that door, because you will interrupt the glory service inside the hall, in which the newly arrived saints are rewarded, in the very place where people will come from the east and the west and will seat in the presence of Moses, Abraham and Isaac, and Jacob in the great day of the Lord's rapture. Beloved, it is worth to reject sin, and the pleasure of the world, that the devil is proposing and putting before us, in order to enter the eternal ages of glory. It's worth rejecting everything that the enemy is proposing us in order to be saved. Then I said to my companion angel, Chapter 7, time is finished. I want to see God. I need to see God. The angel looked at me and said, you are not ready. You cannot see God because you will not be able to bear the glory of God. As he said these words, Jesus Christ rose from his throne and said, here is my Father by my sides. At that moment the heaven entered in celebration and praise. The angel took my hand and said, you cannot see God, let go. We were about to move away. Suddenly, from his throne the Lord called me and said, son, look back. When I looked back I saw the earth. It was beautiful and round. Then I saw a huge hand in marble around the earth, a very large hand. This hand was like approaching the earth in order to shake it upside down. Suddenly, I heard the explosive and thunderous voice of Jesus detonating. It was resounded on the whole heaven and said, Father, wait a little longer, I died for them. He was trembling and said, wait a little more, because I died for these people, I died for the earth. Immediately I noticed the earth left intact in the same place. God's hand that was about to act against the earth was stopped. However, God can no longer bear the ever-increasing smells of the sin of the world rising to heaven. God's anger is held back despite the fact that he cannot bear the smell of sin in heaven anymore. The cup of iniquity of the people of the earth is spilling. I asked the Lord Jesus, when is the rapture happening? Immediately I saw 12 shining and glowing angels holding trumpet, and they were about to sound the trumpet. 6 of these glowing angels were facing the side of the earth and 6 were facing the other side looking at the throne of Jesus where he was sitting. They were like anticipating the order to go ahead and sound the trumpet. The Lord said, are just waiting for God's command to blow the trumpet. Beloved, it is worth to resist the sin and the world while we are waiting for the trumpet of God, for the Lord himself will descend from heaven with a loud command, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet of God, and the dead in Christ will be the first to rise. Chapter 8. The War in the Heavenly. Then the angel of the Lord said to me, Joel, I want to show you something. When he said this, he asked me to look down. I observed where he was pointing, and I saw a tremendous darkness. I could not see anything except absolute obscurity. I told him, I am not seeing anything except blackout. He said, Joel, pay attention and look down in the middle of the dark space. I was observing a region of tremendous darkness when I began to see fireballs appearing and them moving in this dark space. These fireballs were all over the place. There were thousands and thousands of fireballs moving in this region of darkness. When I started looking down from where they were coming up from, the angel said, Joel, these fireball that you are observing in movement in this dark space is the prayer of the saints that are rising and crossing the second heaven in order to get to the throne of God. They travel in the form of torches of fire. There were thousands upon thousands of fireball of all shapes and sizes that were doing zigzag in the firmament. Then I observe a fireball that could not reach heaven, because demons were capturing some of them. Not all the prayer of the saint reached heaven. The angel of the Lord said, we can do anything for these prayers that are opposed by demons, because this is the prayer of believer who lack trust and faith in God. They lack commitment and perseverance in prayer. I saw a demon moving in that dark space trying to catch a fireball in his hand. These were a prayer from a believer whose faith in God was eroding. He no longer believes that God is listening to his prayer. Beloved, every night when you bend your knee to pray, believe that prayer is already going through the cosmos and arriving in the presence of God. Do not bend your knee doubting God. When you bend your knee to pray, believe your prayer is rising and is arriving in the presence of God. Believe that God is listening to the prayer. I had my attention on these flying torches of fire that were rising up in tremendous speed in the firmament. They were traveling the second heaven, which was an extremely dark region. Suddenly, I saw another demon flying in great speed in order to grab another fireball, but he was unable to do so. This prayer outdistanced the devil's hand and arrived in heaven. When this torch of fire entered the kingdom of heaven, it burst open. At that moment I could hear the voice of believer asking the Lord for mercy in his life. As a result, there were movement in this section of heaven. I have never seen this kind of commotion and agitation on the earth. Angels in heaven in God's service move with prodigious speed. Angels were going to and fro in great speed. They were flying all over the place. They were working to present the prayer of the saint on the throne, and they were also getting God instruction in response to the prayer of the saint, which they were to bring to believer. When I observe resplendent and radiant angels in this section of heaven, I noticed that they were holding golden cup on their hands, in which there were yellowish liquid that were glowing with beautiful light. I saw another angel who had a golden censer came and stood at the altar. He was given much incense to offer along with the prayers of all the saints on the golden altar before the throne, and the smoke of the incense with the prayers of the saints rose up before God from the hand of the angel. Then the angel took the censer, filled it with fire from the altar and held it to the earth. And there were peals of thunder and rumblings, and flashes of lightning. At that moment I observe a particular angel. He took a golden goblet and he went out of the throne. My companion angel looked at me and said, Joel, this is the chief angel Gabriel, the messenger from heaven, who is going down to the earth to answer the prayer of a believer. However, when I watched Gabriel going down the firmament, I saw a huge demon appearing in the dark space where Gabriel was flying. This demon did not let Gabriel pass in this dark region. There was continual fightings in the firmament. The chief Gabriel spent the day trying to pass that region in order to respond to the prayer of a particular believer on the earth, but I saw Gabriel flying back again in the kingdom of heaven because he could not pass. At that moment I looked inside the heavenly city of paradise. I saw an angel of light landing before the throne of the Lord. He began to sing a hymn of praise to the Lord. When I looked again, I saw a powerful angel standing by the throne of God near the throne of Jesus. The angel was very beautiful. He had a lot of hair that shone whiter than the snow. He was looking at Jesus. Jesus' attention was not on him. Then Jesus told him to go. Actually, Jesus spoke to the angel through his mind instead of words. When the angel left the throne, I saw thousands and thousands of angels that began to sing for the Lord. As this angel flew away from the throne, I saw him pulling a very huge sword. He shouted a war cry and said, "This war is mine." My companion angel said to me, "Joel, this is the chief angel Michael, the captain of the celestial army." There was agitation, upheaval and excitement in the heavenly regions. I saw turmoil in this section of heaven among the angels of war, as the chief angel Michael rallied for battle. He went down the second heaven. He engaged the huge demon that stopped Gabriel from passing. As the archangel descended to the second heaven, I saw the heavens and the firmament filled thunderclap and lightning, like when a torrential rain is about to fall. I saw tremendous lightning, thunderclap and swords everywhere. When the chief angel Michael engaged the huge demon in the dark region and he overpowered him, the archangel's sword crossed that of the demon until the space and the way was clear in the dark space. At that moment I saw the chief angel Gabriel passing in the middle in order to respond to the prayer of that persevering and persistent believer on the earth. If you are praying to the Lord, you should never give up. You should never stop praying, otherwise angel will not pass in order to bring you an answer. The more we pray, the stronger the angel intervened. When we pray, we unleash a war in the heavenly. The more we pray, the angel will have the upper hand. When we get discouraged and abandon, we doubt God with, the enemy will have the upper hand. Then the companion angel took me by the hand and said, "Son, you will have to come back. God is showing you all these in order to tell the saint on the earth." I said, "I do not want to go back." The angel held my hand and showed me several things, and he said, "These things that I am showing now to you are mysteries. They are for yourself. You are prohibited from revealing these mysteries to the people of the earth." Suddenly I saw the chief angel Gabriel coming to us. He was majestic, awesome and beautiful. The archangel said to me, "My son, I am going on mission on the earth, but when I come back I will have to take you back to the earth because your body is dying. It is imminent to death." I said to the chief angel, "I would like to stay here." At that I saw the chief angel. He bore his heavenly vehicle, which was a chariot of fire that was moving in a tremendous speed. At that moment I began to look like a mirror. The years of my life where I was praying to God for an experience. Later, when I saw Gabriel coming back to take me to earth, I thought in my mind, "I'm going to run away and escape in order to hide around in paradise." Then Gabriel came. He hugged me and gave me his wing, saying, "Son, you must come back in your body that is dying on the earth." Sudden we began to fly in great speed of underneath. I saw as we enter the region of the earth atmosphere, I started to see the cities. Then I saw my neighborhood. I started to see my humble little house. I thought, "We will hit the roof. I'm going to die because of this great speed." I'm not sure I looked at the roofs. We stopped there, and but when I looked at the roof, Gabriel was standing with my spirit on top of my body. Then my spirit entered the of my body that was laying on the bed. He said, "Son, I want to make sure that your spirit has entered into your body and that your body is awake, or else I am not going back." I said to Gabriel, "I need to go back to heaven. I do not want to stay for long, but God has chosen you for his service." When I came back to my body, I was continually speaking unknown tongue. I spent 2 days speaking in tongue of heaven. I could not speak Portuguese.